Hello and welcome to yet another important topic for the day, and that is group discussion. We all know that every eligibility criteria necessarily needs to meet group discussion as one of the important criteria for all interview processes. Group discussion actually makes fear in the mind of job aspirant. Just because they are not prepared, they are underprepared, or they have an apprehension of not speaking in group discussion. So let us clarify once and all and minimize the fear factor which seeps in group discussion. We all know that it's a very, very important activity in academic, business and administrative sphere. Why? Let's take a deep dive and understand. Group discussion, as the name suggests, it means group, a group of 8 to 10 or 12. It's purely subjective to what the panel decides upon. But it's basically to do with a group, and they are made to sit in a circular or semicircular manner where they are given a topic and they are asked to exchange their ideas. So group discussion is nothing but exchange of ideas, thoughts and feelings that can possibly take place in a structured environment. So how does it differ from debate is, group discussion essentially has an inference to be drawn, but debates are inconclusive in nature. So debates happen between two people, one who speaks for and one who speaks against, but group discussion is a discussion which is taking place in a unidirectional. And it has to be an elaborative and exhaustive form of a topic, and that's the reason it has to meet certain inferences or conclusion. An important activity in academic, business and administrative sphere. So it is very important tool to assess communication, not only in college level, but also when you are working in a corporate setup, where you need to communicate, where you need to brainstorm, where you need to strategize, where you need to listen to others and form certain consensus which are purely based on business modules typically run in an organization. It is important for all of us to understand that communication has a very vital and integral part to play a role in all our career, and hence group discussion becomes very, very important, not only to communicate but also to understand what others' perspective is. So it's basically when group has to sit together to decide something, then everybody needs to contribute. A group discussion typically is a group activity, and hence the nuances to learn it at an early stage so that we shape up, we understand. Now the objective of selection in a group discussion is basically a team, so everyone needs to participate and have a clear goal set of playing skills rather than getting it in individually driven. So there are essentially five parameters of group discussion. One is the topic knowledge. The topic is given, so essentially you should be aware of the topic. If you are well read, if you have discussed it somewhere, if you have come across, listened to, I think that's the subject knowledge that we are talking about. And if we have a subject knowledge, the second thing comes up is orally expressing it, communication skills. The third parameter would be leadership skills. The fourth will be team management, how the group behaves. And the fourth and the fifth one and the final one would be forming conclusion. So let's try and understand each and every parameters of group discussion. Group discussion would have essentially topic knowledge. What if you are aware of the topic knowledge? What if you are not aware of the topic knowledge? And what if you are aware and you are not able to speak it up? So let's take each case as it is. If you are aware of a group topic or a topic knowledge, then I think you need not to express all your points. Just think of three major points that you can possibly phrase and explain it to the group exhaustively. So not 5-10 points. I'm telling you the tricks, and it has to be only first 3 points. And every time whenever you open your mouth, you should be speaking 1 point at a time. You should not be preempting all the 3 points just because you are aware of the topic knowledge, just because you are able to express it. No, hold it up. one point at a time will make a lot of difference. I'll tell you how it is. This is the case when you are aware of the topic. What if you are not aware of the topic? Then you should wait for first two or three people to let them speak and understand what they speak. If you are able to bring about some relevance, some points out of the spoken first three spoken member of the team, then I think you should bring about examples of the same. For example, let's say if you are not aware of the pandemic wave 2, then you should be waiting for the first three to speak and then take a leaf out of it. Let's say if people say that learning from the wave 1, sanitization, mask and social distancing are holds the key still in the second wave. If you are able to just bring about an example of any of the three things that have been spoken by the first three speakers, I think you can give an example. Like, yes, the second wave is a little lethal wave, because first wave we could not see, we only heard about people suffering from it. But second wave got us witness in the neighborhood people suffering from the second wave, and that's what made it little fearful. So bring about a relevance, bring about an example. I think one example that you can set from whatever has been spoken by the first two or three speakers would set the ball rolling, and you'd be still counted in the group discussion as an active member. What if people know about the topic knowledge, but they still fear to speak out? For them, I would only drop a hint that speak simple sentences and at least rephrase your sentence by affirmations, positive affirmations of whatever your thought process is. Let's say if sanitization has made you not to fall ill for many a reason, and there were lesser number of patients seen in the doctor's chambers, it's only because of the hand wash. So stress that point that I strongly believe that hand wash and proper usage of sanitizer alone has stopped many a diseases. So I think second wave of corona would also be kind of a prophylactic or a proactive or a preventive measures can be taken, as we have done it in the wave 1. Let us do it and observe it in the wave 2. So maybe if people are not aware if they are aware of the topic and they are not able to express, bring it in your simple phrasing of sentences rather making it a complex one. So subject knowledge for all the three conditions. What comes second is, if you are able to express, always try and express not in a very difficult language. Always choose a simple language, a very simple phrasing that can bring about your point, relevant point to across your team. First of all, most important to oral expression is listen. If you are not able to listen properly, you will definitely fizzle away with a lot of good points. So the first thing first is, a leader also listens. So the first sign of leadership is if you are able to listen to others, what they are speaking, as you are trying to make your point and want other to listen to you. It's other way also, that you need to listen to others while they are making their point. So good communication always starts with active listening. So listening plays an important role. Try and listen to what people say and bring out about relevance to the core point of discussion and the topic knowledge. Clarity of thought and expressions are most important. So whatever you speak, I think you should be very clear. Speak less, but speak effective. That is the point of clarity of thought and expression. And what comes next to clarity of thought is the apt language. Never use a unfamiliar phrase or a decorative language or a flowery language. Always be precise, be polite, be courteous and well-mannered, so that everyone accepts your point as you are able to accept theirs. Always take in help of non-verbal clues as you speak. Your body language should be coherent. It should be incongruence to what you speak. And there should be a proper eye contact to the gesture, to the posture that you make and the facial expressions. Always a smile becomes a contagious aspect of others to become receptive to your communication as well. So align your thought with your verbal and non-verbal cues. The next thing is, other than oral expression that we have seen, the four things that we have seen, let us think about the team behavior. Now, the team behavior is very, very important. You would see that there are good number of people, all are very different. Someone would be initiating, so he becomes a leader. Someone will be an information seeker who wanted to have more insight towards a topic. Someone would be a great giver, information giver. Someone would be a procedure facilitator. He would always say that we are halfway mark, we are left with 1 minute. Let's not divulge this topic to any other subject. Let's come back to on track to the topic, on the topic, and speak relevance. So a procedure facilitator would be, there will be an observer. There will be an opinion seeker who would always seek an opinion from the group or maybe from the people who have not spoken. Someone would be a giver too. Someone would be a clarifier. If the group at large is unable to understand, then there comes a role of the clarifier who clarifies things and put things into perspective. Few are summarizer. They will always be able to summarize with one or two points so that the entire discussion is well understood. There will be a social supporter also, not only within the group, that he or she will make the others to understand that we are sitting with a purpose, so let's take that cause into consideration and let's socially be inclined to it, towards the topic. Someone would be a great social supporter and always try to bring that social angle or element into the discussion. Someone will be a tension reliever, bringing the jokes or the humor part of it. Someone would be a compromiser who will try to compromise, make a compromise between, let's say, two extreme people of different opinion. Someone would be always an Arnab Goswami, an attacker. Someone would be a humorist and someone would be a dominator. So there would be people of different personality traits participating in the same group. Maybe a homogeneous group, so to say, to participate in a group discussion, but it becomes an heterogeneous in nature because there are different personalities participating into it. So that's a typical team behavior that you would like to witness in a group, and let it be dynamic, let it be ever so.